Hello everyone. Hello semuanya. Today we want to share information which can address your problems. Hari ini kami ingin berbagi informasi yang dapat membantu kalian. Alright. Baiklah. Information that we would like to tell you is about sperm. Informasi yang ingin kami sampaikan adalah tentang sperm. As for the generation, sebagai generasi milenial, we should know our nation's history. Kita harus mengetahui sejarah bangsa kita. We believe that everyone of us has heard about sperm. Kami yakin kita semua pernah mendengar tentang sperm. Who was the first president of Indonesia? Yang merupakan presiden pertama Indonesia. But what else do you know? Apalagi tentang sperm? So, jadi let's try to know about it. Ayo kita coba lebih mengetahui. The original name of sperm is Kusno Kusno. Nama asli dari sperm adalah Kusno Kusno. His parents later named Kusno after he survived a serious illness. Orang tuanya kemudian menamainya Soekarno setelah dia selamat dari penyakit serius. He was born on June 6, 1901 in Surabaya. Dia lahir pada tanggal 6 Juni 1901 di Surabaya. His father is Raden Sukeni Sosro. Ayahnya adalah Raden Sukeni Sosro dan his mother is Ida Jumantara. Dan ibunya adalah Ida Nijawakan. Young Soekarno, pemuda Soekarno, went to a local elementary school until 1912. Bersekolah di sekolah dasar setempat hingga tahun 1912. Tidak datang dari sekolah di Mojokerto. Dia kemudian melanjutkan sekolah menengah pertama Belanda di Jawa. Dan kemudian, he continued his high school in 1916. Melanjutkan sekolah menengahnya pada tahun 1916. By that, his high school di Surabaya. Di sekolah menengah atas Belanda di Surabaya. After that, setelah itu, he went to Technical Institute in Bali. Dia melanjutkan ke Institut Teknik di Bali. Soekarno began to think about independence from the Dutch colonies while he was in Bali. Soekarno mulai memikirkan kemerdekaan dari Hindia Belanda saat duduk di bangku SMA. During college, selama kuliah, he earned a degree on different political philosophies. Dia membaca secara mendalam filosofi politik di Hindia, including communism, termasuk populisme, capitalist democracy, demokrasi kapitalis, and Islamism, dan Islamism. Loving his own synthetic ideology of Indonesian socialism, self-sabilis, mengembangkan ideologi sistematis buat membayar sosialis Indonesia. In February 1942, pada Februari 1942, the Imperial Japanese Army invaded Iran to the Sudanese. Tentara kekuasaan Jepang menyerang India Belanda. Kalau kita menemukan bagi zaman education of the Netherlands, terputus dari bantuan oleh penduduk Jerman dan Belanda, the colonial Dutch British colony to the Japanese. Kolonial Belanda segera menyerang kepada Jepang. In June 1945, pada bulan Juni 1945, Soekarno introduced his five plain Pancasila. Soekarno memperkenalkan 53 Pancasila, or principles of an independent Indonesia, atau asas-asas Indonesia bagi kita. On August 18, at 10 a.m., pada 18 Agustus, pukul 10 pagi, Soekarno spoke to a crowd of 500 in front of his home. Soekarno berbicara kepada 500 orang di depan penonton and declared the topic of independent Indonesia dan mendeklarasikan kemerdekaan Republik Indonesia. With himself serving as president and his prime minister, the vice president, dengan menyebut dirinya sebagai presiden dan temannya Muhammad Hatta sebagai wakil presiden. On March 12, 1967, pada 12 Maret 1967, Soekarno was nominated to permanent post from the presidency. Soekarno secara resmi diinginkan dari kursi kepresidenan. So, jadi Soekarno led Indonesia for 23 years. Soekarno memimpin Indonesia selama 22 tahun. Soekarno died of kidney failure in June 31, 1972. Soekarno meninggal karena gagal ginjal 21 Juni 1970 di Jakarta Army Hospital, Rumah Sakit Angkatan Darat Jakarta. He was 69 years old. Dia berusia 60.